In this video, I show you how to use the timeline tools in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at the timeline tools in Shotcut. So to start with, I have created a new project and then dragged in three video clips into the playlist, created two different video tracks on the timeline, and then dragged those video clips into the timeline. And if that doesn't make much sense to you right now, then I suggest starting with one of my beginner tutorials, and I'll link that in the top right corner now and in the description below for you. So now let's focus our attention on the timeline tools, which are just here, and let's work out what each of them do. Now I'm going to start from the right hand side and work towards the left, purely because it's a little bit easier to explain that way, but really each of the tools can be used in any order. So the first section we're going to look at is the plus and minus, and then this square button here. Okay, if we click the zoom tile to fit button, it's going to make your timeline and anything in your timeline fit to the current window. So this timeline, if it was 10 hours long, it would now show you the 10 hours worth of footage that you've got in your timeline. You can manually change that by using the plus and minus buttons, or by using the slider to click and drag. I'll leave mine just like that for now, but these tools help you zoom in and out of the timeline so you can be more precise on some of your editing when you need to zoom in or out. Now the next two tools kind of work in conjunction with each other. The first one we're going to look at is the ripple trim and drop, and then the second one is the ripple edit across all tracks. Okay, so let's explain what that means first. The ripple trim and drop basically means that if I was to drag a new file in here right now into the video track 2 and I drop it over another video track like this, it's going to overwrite the other video. So it doesn't move it, it keeps it in place but places this new video over the top. If I undo that with Control and Z, click the ripple trim and drop, and now do the same thing, it's going to insert this video clip. It's still going to cut it in the right place wherever we've dropped it, but it's going to push the video over. Now that might work for you and that's great, but also you may find that you've got other dependencies on other video tracks which are now misaligned. So by that I mean you've aligned all of your audio and some other effects on a different video track and now they're misaligned, so you actually want all of your video tracks to push with the insert that you've just created. So if I undo that once more and now I click the ripple edits across all tracks, both of these are now blue and highlighted. And I do the same thing, it now cuts all of the tracks and pushes it over. Now, quick tip here, it's very easy to get confused with these two toggles. They do work in conjunction with each other. You can use one individually from the other, or you can use them both at the same time. Just be careful when you've got them on, because if I forget that I've got them on, I could end up moving lots of video clips around that I don't mean to. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. I'm going to undo that once more. I've got these untoggled again, so if you are copying along with this video, then make sure you've got these untoggled as well. The next one across is scrub while dragging. Now this button doesn't work in quite the same way as you may expect, so just be careful when you're using this. But effectively, if I click it and I now try and drag a video around, it's going to move the playhead to the very beginning of that video and keep it attached to that video. So now if I click and drag, you can see it moves over and you can now align with other things on the video. If I release and I try again, but I'll move the playhead just into the middle like it was before, it now doesn't do anything, it stays there. This particular tool, I don't think I hardly ever use. I don't expect that many people would need to, especially as it doesn't do what most video editors would do, and that's a live update as you're scrolling through the video. A lot of people would try and use this to stop the audio from playing whilst you're scrubbing through and moving around the timeline, but actually this button doesn't quite operate in that way. Moving over, we've now got toggle and snap. This is the magnet item. If you've got it toggled on, which I believe most of you will do, then when you drag and you get close to another clip, you see it kind of snaps. So it'll get so close and then it will just drag it to the nearest clip. And that means that you don't have any holes in your video editing. This one is quite commonly used and I keep this on most of the time for my videos. It's entirely up to you if you have it on or off. Just remember that if it's off and you leave a little gap, then if you're zoomed out, you might not be able to see it very clearly. If I zoom out even more, I don't even know that there's a gap there. If I've got it on, I'll just zoom back in a bit to make it easier, then I can know exactly when they're snapped together, so I won't get any unexpected things occurring in my video. The other thing to note is if you take snapping off and then you go close to it, as you can see there, I'm overlapping by 3 frames. Now you may want that, but that actually creates a transition. It's very close, and if you're not exact, then it will start creating extra fades and transitions that you may not be expecting. So another reason to have snapping on. If I undo the timeline effect there, then you won't get any issues like that occurring. Whilst you've got toggle snapping on, it will also snap to your wherever your playhead is. So this line can be used as a snap to grid as well. As we keep on moving over, this one is split at playhead, so most of you will be used to using this button. If you wanted to cut your video, you would click this, and then it will create 2 snips for you. So you've got one to the left and one to the right of the playhead, and you can do that as many times as you want to create as many snips as you need. Okay, so now if we move over, we've got the overwrite clip. And basically what this does is if we select something up here and then put it into the into the timeline by using this button, it will overwrite whatever's here. It's exactly the same as clicking and dragging and overwriting your file like this. It's the same, effectively the same thing. What you can find particularly helpful here is that when you're clicking and dragging, you've got to align everything correctly. Whereas if you use the button, you can get it to the exact frame that you want it at and then add it in. So it depends on the precision that you need and how you want to work with your files. Sometimes you need the precision, and then adding in this button here is the main thing to do. So quick one to note that if you've got the ripple effects turned on and you use this effect, it will not push everything over like you may expect it to. This is the overwrite button and it will not do an insert. Okay, so if I take these back off again. So now moving over to the lift, if I wanted to remove this piece of content, then I can lift it, and what that will do is it will not move anything around, it will just leave it there. And then moving into the next one, you've got the minus, which is the ripple delete. So if I now push this one, it will move everything up. Okay, so you've got one that doesn't move the timeline at all and one that does move the timeline. Be aware of which one you want to use at the right times. I'm undoing once more. And now moving over to the append, doesn't matter where your playhead is, if you add in a new clip, it's going to append it to the very end of the track that you're on. Now the last few little buttons that we've got here, the cut, copy and paste, they're fairly obvious, hopefully. You've got copy, which will copy the current clip, and then you can paste it wherever you want with the next button there, and you could do that as many times as you want to. You can also push it onto a separate track. So wherever you copy and paste, it will perform the way you're expecting it to. The cut option will cut the current selection and move everything backwards as well. So make sure that if you do cut, that you want it to cut. Otherwise, you want to lift it with this button. Obviously, the bonus with cut is you can then paste it back in somewhere else where you want it. Now, the very last part is your track operations. When I'm using these, I generally right click and I get exactly the same options. So to create multiple tracks or layers, then you've got your add audio tracks and add video tracks. You can also insert an additional track or remove existing tracks. I won't demonstrate that here, but I do have another video on it. So if you're interested in learning how to use layers and tracks, then I'll link in the description below for you. You've also got some handy tools here where if you're using a lot of tracks, you might want to make the tracks a little bit smaller or in some cases a little bit taller. So you can visually see more or less of the timeline by using those tools. You've also got the select all option, which will just select everything. So let's say I wanted to start my project again. I could select all and delete, or I could even just move it all over slightly to make space for some extra content that I need. You've also got the select none. So if you've got something selected and you want to deselect everything for whatever reason that might be, you can do that there. You've got a few various options to go over. The ripple all tracks is the same as this option here. Just another place to get to it. You can show or hide the audio waves on your video clips. Sometimes that can be helpful or distracting, so that can be turned on or off. If you have the option to keep this ticked, then I would, but if you're struggling with your audio quality, then you may want to take this off. The video thumbnails are these little icons in the corner here. Just depicts what you've got in your playlist and what's actually on the video clip. Completely up to you if you show or hide. The center at playhead button may be helpful on longer videos. Let me zoom in slightly to demonstrate it. It will now make sure the playhead is always in the very center of the screen, no matter what I do. And as a note, I can still leave my playhead in there whilst I'm clicking around or dragging the scroll bar, but as soon as I click on the timeline somewhere, it will center. So I don't personally use that. I'm going to turn that one off. And then you've got scroll to playhead on zoom as well. So whenever I click plus or minus, it's going to zoom back to where the playhead is. I keep that on, but you may want to toggle it on or off. You've got some other options here that I won't go over in too much detail. The copy timeline to source is something that you can do, and what that will do there. It might take a few seconds to load, but once it has, it will put your whole source, it will put your whole timeline that you've created into your source. There's also some other things you can do with that, but we'll cover that in another video. And then the very last thing, if you're having any trouble, you can reload Shotcut. If you've got any problems with that at all, I'd recommend saving first. The last few things to consider are the video track outputs and actually the audio outputs as well. Let me add an audio track here quickly. Let me add something to it as well, just so you can see it working. And here you've got three options for your video track. You can lock it so nothing can happen. I can't drag or add anything to this track now. You can turn the sound on or off, and then you've got show or hide the video track itself. So this layer will either be visible or not visible, and that can help sometimes when you're trying to do some effects and things like that. Generally speaking, by the time you come to the export, you want these to be visible. And same for the audio track. Obviously, there's nothing to see, so you don't have the hide visibility option. You've just got the audio on, audio off, and lock items. So I know we've gone through a hell of a lot in this video. Firstly, thank you for staying with me. But secondly, I hope this has given you a very good outline. Your main focus for these tools will be along this section here, where you've got all of your editing and cutting that you can perform. And then this set of tools here that allows you to navigate and maneuver the clips around. You'll probably also find yourself using these tools to zoom in and out on the video tracks, depending on what you're doing with these. But ultimately, they all work together in quite a nice, concise way, allowing you to edit your videos quickly and effectively. I hope this video has been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one.